हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द टॉपिक इनविटेशन राइटिंग। द सेम टॉपिक वाज डिस्कस्ड बाय अस इन द लास्ट टू लेक्चर्स एंड नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी वुड आल्सो लाइक टू लर्न सम मोर इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू दिस टॉपिक इनविटेशन राइटिंग। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इनफॉर्मल इनविटेशंस। ओके, पार्ट टू। What is the part 2? Informal invitations. Part 2 is here. Informal invitations. Okay. Informal. P-A-R-T. Part 2. Informal invitations. Informal invitations. Informal invitations. Dear students, informal invitations are totally different from the formal invitations. Informal invitations are written in the form of letters. Informal invitations are also known as non-printed invitations. So, dear students, here are two parts of informal invitations. The first one formal and the second one informal. Informal invitations also contain three things. First, format. The second, content matter. And the last one, expression. If you write the format exactly correct, you will be awarded one mark. If you write the content matter as per the requirement of the heading, you will be awarded two marks. And if you write the each and every statement without making any grammatical mistake, you will be awarded one mark. So now, informal invitations. First of all, I would like to give you here blank format. What kind of format? Blank format. This is the blank format which surely help you understand the structure of writing, the structure of writing informal invitations. Dear students, get yourself ready. Don't be lazy. Always be active while attending the online lecture video. Online lecture video, whether it is of mine or it is somebody else, it doesn't matter. All lecturers give their best for the welfare, for the upliftment of the students, and I think you are getting full benefit of these all lectures as being delivered by all faculties in English and other subjects also. So now I am going to write here format. F-O-R-M-A-T, format. And this the format is blank format. Okay. So dear students, when we start drafting an invitation, when we start drafting an informal invitation, we have to work under these all steps. The first step relates to self-address. Address of the inviter. Here you will write the address of the inviter. So I will write here address, A-D-D-R-E-S-S, address of the host or inviter. Inviter, host or organizer. G-A-N-I-S-E-R, organizer. Okay, this is N. Organizer. The first of all, you will have to write the address of the host, organizer or inviter, whose address will be in the heading. You will find the address in the heading. Then one line is to be dropped just like the formal letters, and you will have to write here the date, current date. Now again skip one more line here and write down the address of the addressee, invitee. Address of invitee. But dear student, one thing which you will have to learn in different way. This the address of invitee is to be written. This the address of invitee is to be written in the cases when you are going to invite some official persons. For instance, you want to invite the chairman of CBSE board, you want to invite the health minister of the state government of Haryana. Okay, so then you will have to mention the name of the address of the invitee. Okay, whom you are going to invite. If you are going to invite the any person of your relations, any person from your relations, any friend, so then in that case you will not write the address of the invitee. Got it or not? If you have not understood it, I tell you here in detail. This the address is compulsory in both kinds of informal invitations. I have already given you the two types of informal invitations, the names of two types of informal invitations. The first one is formal and the second one is informal. So this the format is only for formal invitations. I write here detail. Format 2, FORMAT, format 2, formal, okay, of informal invitations. Informal invitations. Okay, format 2, formal of informal invitations. This is the first part, formal. When we write any informal invitation to any official person, when we write an informal invitation to any official person, chair person, authority person, so it is known as a formal part of the informal invitation. And when you write the informal invitation to any relative person, so then in that case it would be described as the informal part of informal invitations. So now for both types of informal invitations, this the best address is mandatory. Address of the inviter. Now the second step is for current date, the third step is address of the invitee, the fourth step is your subject, S-U-B-J-E-C-T, subject. In subject you will write here invitation as chief guest, invitation as a guest of honor, invitation as a judge, invitation as a coach. Okay, you can write here, this is the subject in this way, or you may write in some other way also. You can also write the subject in small letters except the first letter. Okay, first letter should be written in capital and the remaining all letters can be written in small letters. Invitation to attend, to be the chief guest, or to attend, to grace the occasion as a chief guest, like this. You can also mention the, I would like to give you the details when we when we start getting the solution of some informal notation after providing you the heading. So it is a blank format. Okay. Now you would like your sir or madam. Whether sir or madam, it depends on the nature of the heading. Sir or madam, any one of these two words, salutation words, you should write any single one. Then we will start writing here the content matter. It will be the content matter. I will write here, this is the content matter later. This is the content matter, should be written in 2 or 3 lines. Okay, it should be in about 30 to 40 words. And then you should write here the last sentence also, complimentary clause, and the box will be closed. This is the blank format, dear students. And now I would like to give you a heading and the solution, okay, to this informal notation. Heading. Dear students, now I write here a short heading. Okay. You are the principal of Kalpana Public School, Karnal. Your school is going to organize a an inter-school speech competition contest at the school campus. On 16th April 2020, full stop. You want to invite the Mr. R.K. Arora, a noted professor at Central University Pali, Mahendragarh. To grace the program, to grace the occasion, as a judge. Write or draft an invitation, an informal invitation, inviting the professor for the upcoming competition as the chief judge. You are the principal of Kalpana Public School, Karnal. Your school is going to organize an inter-school speech contest at the school campus on 16th April 2020. You want to invite Mr. R.K. Arora, a noted professor at Central University Pali Mahendragarh, to grace the occasion as a judge. Draft an informal invitation inviting the professor for the upcoming competition as the chief judge of the panel. So this is the heading. Now you will write the we will write here the complete solution, okay, to this heading. And the heading, as you can see here, is very simple heading. Name of the program is also mentioned here. Name of the person is also mentioned here. Now two addresses are also given here. The first address belongs to the inviter. You are the inviter, principal, Kalpana Public School, Karna. It's your address, self address. Okay, the address of the inviter, and it is the name of the program, okay, and this is the address. This is the address, Central University Pali, address of the invitee. So these two things are urgently required by us, and we have got all these two things here. Now we are here to write this invitation in detail. Okay. Okay, dear students, this is the solution. Now, pay your attention to this solution. Very easy solution. First of all, you should write here the principal. Here, you should write here informal invitation. Invitation, TATION. I have already told you that you should write the name of the topic which you are going to attempt here in your answer sheet. So you should write here the name of the topic, invitation. No need to write here formal, informal. If you write here the informal invitation, you can also write the name of the invitation and type of the invitation into bracket. Okay, first of all, the principal, PRINCIPAP, should be in capital. Okay, Kalpana Public School, KALPANA, Kalpana Public, PUBLIC, Public School, 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 Karnal, KARNAL. Again, drop one line here. This is 31st March 2020. Okay. Now you will write here the address, the professor. PROFESSOR. Okay, Central University. Okay, and Central University Pali Mahendragarh, MAHENDERGARH Mahendragarh. This is the address. Now you may be thinking that we have not written the name of the professor. So here are number of professors at the University of Pali. Dear students, you will have to write the name of this professor, the content matter also. And if you think that you should write the name of the professor, then you can write here into bracket, Mr. R. K. Arora, A-R-O-R-A, Professor Mr. R. K. Arora, Central University, Pali Mahendragarh. Okay, so now you will have to write here what you should write here the subject. You should write here the subject, one thing.